Big changes coming to the Jeep Gladiator. Something new. Well, to me anyway. Well, good afternoon, everybody, and welcome back to Robmotive JT. And that's right, there are some big changes coming to my Jeep Gladiator. Big changes in that it's not gonna be here anymore. Now, I'm not getting out of the Jeep Gladiator full. However, I am going to be updating the truck. You know, for quite a long time now, I've posted videos here or there about going to something else, trading in the Jeep Gladiator for something else, and an opportunity has arisen, or at least it will be arising. It's going to be a little bit later in the year, still going to be doing things with this truck, but it's probably going to be in the form of getting it ready for its next owner. And I'll get into all that later on. What I'm doing, I'm going to be trading this out, swapping it, if you will, for a Jeep Gladiator Mojave. Now, there's going to be some parts and things that are going to be swapped out as well. There are some things on this Jeep Gladiator that I'm going to want to keep that the new owner does not want. So, things such as the Sunrider soft top. We'll be putting the Freedom panels back on my white Jeep Gladiator and putting the Freedom panels back on. Also, going to be changing out the bumper. Right now, of course, I have the three-piece Rubicon-style bumper you can see right here, along with the lights that I put on and the green tow hooks. Well, the new owner wants the OEM-style bumper. In other words, the straight-across bumper that comes out a little bit further on each side. So, we're going to be swapping this bumper out for an OEM, or the OEM bumper that came with it. It's pretty simple to do. It's really just a bolt-on application. I will have to disconnect the lights, so that's a little bit more complicated, I guess, but not too bad. The lights will be going eventually on the Gladiator Mojave. Got some plans, big plans for the Mojave. Gonna make some bumper changes, some other things like that, but we'll get into that a little bit later on. Now, a few other things that are going to be happening with the white Jeep Gladiator. We're going to be getting rid of the green accent colors. The new owner doesn't want green. She wants black. So we're actually going to, as I mentioned, put the OEM bumper on. It comes with black tow hooks on the front. Not a big deal there. But we are going to have to do something with the tow hooks on the back. I did go ahead and put the OEM cutouts in, if you will, so that I could have two tow hooks on the back. And of course, I went with the green color. What I'm gonna do here is pull the rear bumper, take the tow hooks off, which is very simple to do. I think there's three bolts, and then go ahead and paint those black. Then they'll match the front. Now, the Jeep lettering. All of that right now, of course, has the stickers, the applications, if you will, from Tough Skins, which, by the way, as you can see, have held up really, really well. They look really good on the truck. But as I mentioned, the new owner does not want green, so we're going to have to pull these off, which I'm hoping should be pretty easy. Maybe a little bit of adhesive left on the back, should be able to get those off pretty simply, I think. Up on the sides, we do have the, again, Jeep green lettering. Same thing, it's just a stick-on application, should be able to pull those right off. And then we have the green Jeep trail rated badge. Now, I haven't decided how I'm going to approach this. She does not want green, she wants black. So I could pull this one off and paint it black. The letters and stuff, or rather the background parts, are already black, so that shouldn't be that difficult to do. I could just buy a new one and stick it on. I'm leaning that way a little bit. I may do that because, frankly, it's easier to do. We shall see. As far as the wheels and tires, she may change the wheels out, or the tires rather, later herself. We are going to be leaving the wheels that are there on. She will be getting it with the tires that are on it now. It's possible, maybe, that I could put these tires on the Jeep Mojave, the Gladiator Mojave, because I do like these and they're a bit less aggressive than what's on it now. If you didn't know, what comes on the Mojave are the mud terrains. They're a heck of a lot more aggressive, deeper tread, if you will, and frankly, they make a lot more noise on the road too, is to mention a firmer ride. I like the Falcon Wild Peaks. I think they're the best tires that I've ever had. Even if I don't go with the ones that are here on the Mojave, I will be replacing those mud terrains, which are, by the way, Falcon Wild Peaks, but I will be replacing those with more of something like this. These are an AT, which I'm assuming stands for all terrain, and they certainly are the best ones that I've had. Now, a couple of other things. We will be leaving the side steps on, so that's not going to change. The window tent, obviously, that's not going to change. That's not something that you can easily pull off. Under the hood, we do have the Air Raid cold air intake. Now, I'm not quite sure what she's going to do about that just yet. I think she likes it. In that case, we'll leave it on. There will be a new cold air intake for the Jeep Gladiator Mojave. I haven't decided quite yet whether I'll go with an Air Raid there or maybe try to experiment with something else in between, because to my experience so far, the Air Raid cold air intake is the best that you can get when it comes to sound. I like that throaty note that it gives. And the other one, I think only one other one, it was Volant, I think, that I tried on this Jeep Gladiator didn't give me the kind of sound that I wanted. Matter of fact, I really couldn't hear anything different out of it other than what stock sounds like. So I wouldn't go with that one, although I did like the looks of it. And by the way, that was sent to me by a subscriber. If you're still out there, thanks again for doing that. I really do appreciate it. Other plans for the Mojave, as I mentioned, I'm gonna change the bumpers out on them, or on it rather. Definitely a front bumper, which means I have to do the rear bumper. I don't think on the Mojave you can get away with leaving the stock bumper on it and changing out the front. I think it's just too much of an aggressive looking truck to do that. As far as color accents go, probably not a lot there, because everything is color matched already with that Mojave orange theme. So I'm not thinking I'm going to change any of that kind of stuff out. But it's going to be very interesting to experience that truck as compared to the Sport S out there, because it is a completely different setup. We have the Fox suspension. It does have, I believe it's a 2-inch lift, 1.5, 2-inch, I forget, I would have to look. So it is going to be higher. And by the way, that's part of the reason that the person that's taking this one is taking this one, because they want something a little bit lower. And the Mojave, with its bigger tires, that gives you about 0.5-inch lift, and its 2-inch suspension lift gives you about 2.5 inches of lift. So she should be good to go with the Sport S at this height. By the way, I really do love this one. I've never had any issues with it. And I will say the Mojave that I'm going to be replacing it with, as I mentioned, is used. It's got about 3,000 miles, a little bit less on it. And there haven't been any problems with it either. None of the start, stop, check engine light, battery, auxiliary problems that I had on my first Gladiator, which was the Gobi, which, by the way, I still do miss that color. I love that color. Anyway, I just thought I'd give you guys a bit of an update. There are big changes coming for my Jeep Gladiator in the form of there's going to be something new. Now, I will show taking things off and changing things around, because I know sometimes folks want to do that themselves, and I thought it would be interesting to show just how difficult is it to take some of these mods off once they're already on. So stay tuned for that. Not going to be happening until later in the year, probably third quarter, but as quickly as this year is going, that's going to come up pretty fast. Leave a comment. Let me know what you think. Are you interested in seeing the Jeep Gladiator Mojave on the channel, or not so much? I'd be curious to know. Also, real quick, I do have two additional channels. Rob Motive, all about the Toyota Tacoma, and Rob Motive MT, all about mini trucks. Currently, the 2022 Hyundai Santa Cruz. Check them out, and if you're interested, please consider subscribing. Thanks for watching. Lots of exciting things to come. Stay safe out there. Bye.